I never stop building. We've got another one on the bench. You saw it in the previews. 120 pieces, 1/25th scale, monogram Chevy S10, the Street Fighter. This thing is all-wheel drive and turbocharged 4.3, sent over by Revell USA. So let's take a look at everything in the box. Fresh from the model car tire tree are these sweet-looking no-name tires. Now, there is no name on the sidewall, but that tread pattern looks like a Goodyear to me. But hey, the experts on the internet are always happy to correct when I'm wrong, so they'll do so in the comments. We got the body, we got the interior, we got that ubiquitous S10 body. Man, these things were around for a long time, and it seems like they sold a million of them. If they didn't, they had to have been close, because these things were all over the country, especially in the Midwest. Out in the coast states, they always hot rodded them like this one. You got that nice interior tub. We've got separate door panels that will slide in to that tub instead of being glued on the side. These will actually slide down in. Makes for a secure fitment when you're sliding it up inside the body, that you know you don't have them too wide. We've got numerous drivetrain details. We've got a skid plate, we've got a transfer case, serpentine belt pulley system. We've got some axles in there. Axle Foley from Beverly Hills Cop. That's what I think of every time I hear axle. We got the S10 bucket seats. My Jimmy had these exact seats in a gray and black tone, like almost like a tweed. We got that nice dashboard. Firewall. We've got radiators. We've got individual windshield wipers. Be careful. We got the steering column. We got the seat backs and various small parts like visors and side mirrors. Be very careful with those side mirrors. Don't break the mirrors. We got the exhaust here. I don't know how they molded that in one piece, but that's pretty awesome. Converter, dual muffler to the pipes out. We've got the drive shaft, fan. We got that 4.3 liter V6. Wheel backs, various engine parts, heads, valve covers, water pumps, master cylinder, steering wheel. So be careful with those trees, you don't lose anything. We've got our rear suspension system, drivetrain, torsion bar suspension, made these trucks really easy to lift at least a couple inches. Got our full frame here, an underbody all in one piece with the spare mounted in. Here we've got a whole bunch of manifolds, hoses, lines. We've got turbo parts, air boxes, steering linkages, power steering pump. Definitely need power steering with a turbocharged all-wheel drive S10. We've got the box here. We've got the box sides. Nice depth of molding in there. We've got the tailgate exterior and interior. We got that slab hood on the S10s. We got that center console with cup holders molded in. We got some trim pieces for under the box, the stiffeners for underneath the box there. Tons of parts and detail parts. Very detailed kit. Let me go to the other side of the desk. We've got two types of taillights. The ones with the nice black frames around them and the ones with the smooth. My Jimmy was actually an 85, so it had the silver. The black frame taillights weren't available yet. Looks like part of the air dam there molded in clear. On this clear tree, we've got an option of sliding rear glass, solid rear glass, windshield, headlights and taillights, marker lights for different generations. We've got one chrome tree, and they spot on nailed those GM 5-spoke wheels, except I never saw any that were chrome. I'm sure there were, but they were always that brushed aluminum that pitted horribly after only a few years. We got that nice grille on there, molded open. We got the front and rear bumpers. Remember these grills when they were molded in that dark gray plastic and they hit them with a hammer on the ad, that tough grill, that tough plastic? And the first time it was out in the cold in the Wisconsin weather and someone would go, "Is that the tough grill?" And they'd smack it and it would crack in half because they didn't design them for the cold. We got lots of engine dress-up parts here for the turbos. We got headlight buckets. We got the little mirrors in there for the side view mirrors. I go off on a tangent talking about cool stuff that I remember. We've got the nice new decal sheet. Underhood insulation is what that is. Three gauge options, custom and stock. We got gorgeous S10 emblems. We got some striping, two types of striping. Turbo emblems, GM parts, performance emblems, windshield emblems for Chevrolet. Got three different kinds of those. Red, white, and black. Red, white, and silver for the tailgate. We got all kinds of license plates on this thing. Small details for under the hood. We got the gold Chevy emblem for the grill. Excellent, excellent decal package. I'm going to put together my version, and we'll see you soon. Building up my custom S10, the dream of a ton of us in the 90s to build these up, late 80s. Most common thing to do is drop a 350 or a 305 in them, and they really flew. But also was the turbo 4.3 that was available in the Cyclones and the Typhoon cars. This one, being a stock body S10, is a definite sleeper as it is, and I'm building it as a custom version the way I'd want to do it if I did it. Now we've got the manual transmission with the shifter in that center tunnel, that center console with the cup holders. That's on its tree. We got that ready to paint. Got the gauge cluster glued onto the dashboard. That's going to be all set up and ready to go. I got the seat backs glued onto the seats. They fit perfectly. All the fits in this kit have been absolutely wonderful. You can tell that this kit was designed in the 90s, more modern tooling and everything, and the seat detail is exquisite, exactly matches. On this tree, I have the mirrors, the wipers, and the radiator, and the sun visors. I want all of those the same color, so that's very handy to cut that tree free and put it aside. I was right, this is the air dam, the optional air dam for underneath the front bumper with that textured plastic. My GMC Jimmy had one too, so I will be painting that up and getting ready to install that under the bumper. We've got this trim piece for across the front of the two fenders. Now on the real S10s in the real life, if you were building an exactly stock S10, the area, the fenders would be black. This cross piece would be black. The firewall would be body color, but if you're building a custom one, you do whatever you want, because when they build them, they paint them the way they want. They don't worry about what some guy on the internet thinks, so that's what I'm gonna do. We've got our skid plate here and our transfer case. Now this could be black, this could be silver. You decide what color you want it. I've got them on the same tree, so I think we know what color I'm gonna be going with those. Our wheel package, these are definitely the dressy four-wheel drive rims. On my GMC, one of the spokes had 4x4 stamped into it. This one doesn't have that fine a detail, but they are spot on for those five-wheel spokes. I'm gonna be painting mine up a different color than chrome and decorating those. We're gonna see how that goes. Got the steering column ready to go. The Chevy soft touch safety steering wheel. We got the serpentine belt and pulley system and the power steering pump. The alternator will be attached later because it's chrome. I'll dull it down and attach it, but all the rest of this can be attached. I glued the fan on, the clutch if you want it to remain metallic. Just use a silver Sharpie on there and it'll bring it right out for you. The air box and the radiator lines are all the same color with a little bit of metallic detail on the end. So we'll get that painted up by hand after we spray it. The front bumper can all be done chrome. It can be done you can flat coat it and do it that soft metallic, or you can do a plastic painted, which is what I'm gonna end up doing on mine. So I've got those covered right there. On this tree, everything that I want to paint up in a metallic color, the wheel backs, the master cylinder, and then I'll paint the cover of it black. The fuel tank and the exhaust and the drive shaft I'll all be doing in natural metal, and it's awesome that they're all on the same tree. Makes my life handy and easy. We've got the interior tub and the door panels. GM interiors aren't all that exciting with colors and designs. We can get that primed and painted together. The chassis here, parts we actually had to assemble. Beautiful 4.3 liter turbocharged six cylinder. We've got everything glued together because I want everything to be very solid. Most of this engine is black. What I will be doing is going in and painting the turbo and some of the air boxes and stuff a metallic color. The manifolds attach with very soft attachment points, so I glued those on first to make sure I could get them on and glued tight with that crossover pipe and fit in the chassis perfectly. Now I will be hand painting that once it's all done. You know, I love doing that. The frame itself goes together absolutely wonderful, the chassis and drivetrain. Now to assemble the exhaust, once I put the torsion bars on, we're gonna have to cut it. You can see where it mounts in these little pinholes here. So it's not gonna be a problem. It's just gonna run out the back and all that. The fuel tank will drop in from the other side right into there. So we're not gonna have any issues. I wanted this all as a solid assembly first. Detail it, then I can just clip my exhaust off right behind the catalytic converter, cut it off and push it in from the other side, and we'll get it on there without a fight or anything like that. It goes over the top. We'll be able to get it free since the frame is free. This is the only part we'll have to cut to get it underneath the torsion bar mount there for those long torsion bars that go forward on the suspension. Nicely detailed. Separate A-arms on the top. I always number them with a marker before I cut them off so I remember which to put on which side. Got our front drivetrain. Our rear drivetrain is all looking good, and our permanent spare tire, which we're not going to worry about. We'll get this all painted up. And it slips underneath the body very nicely. Just pops right in. There are holes in the bottom, or there are pins in the bottom of the box where this will push onto to make sure that you've lined everything properly. And we'll have that all installed without problem, I think, at the end of the video. Got our taillights mounted in. These are chrome to make the taillights shine. I'm going to just end up repainting mine with a Molotow pen because they're integral to assembling the tailgate in the box and getting everything to line up so that it's nice and straight. Then the box just slides up into its grooves on the back of the body. We glue it together. Then we know we have everything lined up. Our trim lines are lined up on both sides. We're not going to look like the truck's been beat up or rusted or have the box warped, and I can repaint those. I glued my tailgate shut. I don't plan on opening it, but you can have an operating tailgate on this kit if you so choose. And our underhood detail and firewalls all glued into place. So that is this awesome kit. Of course, it's not as big as a full size. It's an S10. They weren't that big. I am going to start taking all this stuff over to the paint department, and I'll see you there. One more looky-loo at our super cool drop-in retrofit turbo 4.3 into a regular old S10, and you can check it out. I've got the windshield in, glued in. I've got the underhood painted up, got all the reservoir tanks and overflow tanks and master cylinder all put in there, and that looks pretty cool just the way it is. So that's nice. The paint I used on the inner fenders was a Tamiya semi-gloss. Dries nice and quick and looks wonderful. Look how sweet that package. Now that's painted right over the chrome. Still retaining all the details. Just got to put that gold bow tie. You could also use a gold pen if the decal isn't working out for you. Got the turn signals in the front bumper. Got our rear bumper painted up. Got our headlights in. Got those bezels glued in the back. So those look awesome. That is definitely the look of the S10 spot on. Got our air box here. Our radiator hoses are all set to be put on the vehicle when we install things. Got our radiator done up in a semi-gloss, like it would have been on the real one, kind of shiny. Left the skid plate. You could do this in black, but it's got this little grill here. I like the look of it, so I did it in that hammered silver, same as the exhaust and the fuel tank. On this tree here left over are our mirrors, which I've glued in the reflective glass, and the windshield wipers and the visors that I'll be putting in the interior. In flat black, we've got that plastic air dam. My GMC Jimmy had one of these too. That nice little air dam that goes around the bottom, that I did in flat black. I've got the AC unit right here, which we'll be plugging in, or the heating in the AC unit. I will be treating that with some dull coat before I place that in the vehicle so it's not as shiny, but it still looks like metal. What else do we have to look at? The interior. You saw me do that dashboard up, so you got a much better view of it. We got the black carpet. I use that gray wash on the seats and on the door panel and on the dashboard, and we have a very respectable looking General Motors interior. I use the white round gauge package because, being a drop-in, the stock gauge package did not have the four gauges on the outer edges, and I wanted that in there. And then I'd use the black steering wheel. That was pretty common in a lot of them, no matter what interior you picked. So we got that all set up with the floor shifter console. He is ready to go in his little mini truck. And then we get to that 4.3 liter turbo dropped in the chassis with the transfer case. We got all the detail underneath of the mild rust and wear on the chassis. We got that gorgeous wheel and tire package on there with the sanded tires. And we are looking tough. So we're all set to go. You can see how the exhaust, I cut it right behind the catalytic converter, like I said, glued it up, and it all lines up just fine. Runs out the back, used a black marker on the tips of the exhaust. Left the engine and transmission alone, but did give a light dirtiness to the transfer case and everything else. So we are all set. Those engines being black, I did highlight some stuff with a silver pen, like the fins on top of the valve covers. Things where you get wear points on as they get older. We are all set. That's just going to drop over the top like so. We're going to put our pieces in. We got to put our interior up inside and then decide which decal sets we want to use on the model. You can see there's two gauge sets left over. We got the Chevy emblem. We got locks, but I just detailed mine on with a black Sharpie. And the door handles, but they are on the decal sheet if you choose to use them. We got some mini bow ties. We got tailgate logos. We got little mini turbo logos. S10 logos for the side of the fenders and everything else. So I'm going to decide how I want to dress mine up. We'll see it in just a second. And there we are. The Chevy S10 in 1/25th scale by Monogram. Sent over by Revell USA, a sweet kit that's out right now. It is the sleeper mode. You could do it as the box top. Me, if I'm going to put that much work to drop in a turboed 4.3 into an older S10, I'm going to put some fender stripes on it. I'm going to put the turbo logos on it. I'm going to let people know that I put some work on it. Black out the bumpers, gunmetal the wheels with a nice shiny metal trim ring on them. Black out my taillights and just really make it look tough. And that's exactly what I did here. You can see underneath, we did that little bit of weathering on it, made it look real nice. And then we've got it all together. Now, final build notes, final things to put together, the mirrors and the windshield wipers go on flawlessly because of those locating holes. The interior fits inside the cab very, very tightly. You want to put the front end in first and kind of push forward on the firewall, and then slide the back up and in so you don't pop your chairs loose inside, which I did twice. It does fit very tightly, but it will go in and it will push all the way up without having to shave anything or fight with it or break anything in the process. And with that nice big back window and those open doors, you can see everything inside really well. Other than that, the entire engine compartment fits in there. There's a lot of piping and wiring and air intakes and exhaust. Everything lines up and everything fits. You can see the tires end up in the center of the wheel wells. They push onto the axles and they just snap right into place and fit well. Everything looks great. So pick up this kit, paint it the way you want it, weather it, beat it up. It's got a turbo six-cylinder and four-wheel drive. You could even lift this kit a little bit and put some aftermarket off-road tires on it. The sky is the limit. Or you could drop it down a little bit, put on some hoopty wheels, and really make it a street machine, whatever you like. You can see I use that white Chevrolet logo across the top of the windshield. Everything's well done where you have to put your rubber seals around the doors and in the glass and on the windshield where it's smoked out. I did that all with a black Sharpie, and you saw how I do it. You just trace the lines that are there from the factory, and it looks absolutely great when you're done. The decals went down, had no issues breaking. On that Impala I did, the black ones broke. These are the same size, and I didn't have any issues, so it was just a flaw in that one kit. There's no issues with the Revell decals. Make sure you use a little pin wash in those vents so that those look a little more realistic. I love this white sand color. Just a nice color, looks wonderful. Everything on the kit lines up, and it was a joy to build for you guys, build my version of the no-nonsense turbo S10 four-wheel drive with the 4.3 under the hood from the Syclone. Thanks for watching the workshop. Make sure you always build for you. I will have a link in the description where you can snag this from Model Roundup right now and get it to your house before Christmas. We will see all of you at the next review.